नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, व्हाट इज द ओरिजिन एंड प्रोग्रेस ऑफ क्वांटिटेटिव रिवोल्यूशन इन ज्योग्राफी एंड ब्रिंग आउट इट्स मेरिट एंड डिमेरिट। द क्वांटिटेटिव रिवोल्यूशन वॉज द पैराडाइम शिफ्ट दैट सॉट टू डेवलप ए मोर रिगोरियस एंड सिस्टमेटिक मेथोडोलॉजी फॉर द डिसिप्लिन ऑफ ज्योग्राफी। सो इट केम एज रेस्पॉन्स टू द इनएडिक्वेसी of regional geography to explain general spatial dynamic. You are led to shift from a descriptive ideographic geography to an empirical lawmaking nomothetic geography. In the early 1950s, there was a growing sense that the existing paradigm for geographical research was no adequate in explaining physical, economic, and social and political processes which are spatially organized, or how outcomes generated by them are evidence for a given time and space. A growing number of geographers started to explain the desertification with the traditional paradigm of the discipline and its focus on regional geography. To address these concerns, early critics such as Ackerman suggested systematic of the discipline, the Skipper versus Hudson debate. So this debate has been a keen point in the evolution of quantitative revolution. In his book Exceptionalism and Geography, Methodological Examination, Skipper rejected Hudson's exceptionalist interpretation of the discipline of geography and of having the region as its central object of study. Instead, Skipper envisioned as the discipline main objective the establishment of morphological law through scientific inquiry, that is incorporating laws and methods from other disciplines in the social sciences that place a greater emphasis on processes. Hudson was a positive view of geography. Geography is what geographers have made it. Skipper's view, on the other hand, was a normative one. What geography should be, irrespective of what it had been. By the end of 1950s, geographers in increasing numbers veered around to Skipper's view of geography as a special science. The institutionalization of systematic geography took place throughout the US as the University of Lawrence So Harold McCarty led efforts to establish laws of association between geographical patterns as the University of Wisconsin. Arthur Robinson led efforts to develop statistical method for map comparison, and at the University of Washington, Edward Ullman and William Garrison worked on developing the field of economic and urban geography and central place theory. Some of the techniques that epitomized the quantitative revolution include descriptive statistics, inferential statistics, and basic mathematical models and equations such as gravity model of social physics. The stochastic model, using concepts of probability such as special difference model, deterministic model, that is von Thunen, and Weber's location model, locational analysis using system approach, Peter Haggett. The greater use of computers in geography also led to many new developments of geomatics, such as creation and application of GIS and remote sensing. These new developments allow geographers for the first time to access complex models as field scale models over space and time. The overwhelming focus on statistical modeling ultimately led a backlash against Mr. Cuver. Backlash against quantitative revolution. So many geographers become increasingly concerned that these techniques removed the human dimension from the discipline that always prided itself on studying the human and natural world alike. By 1970s, geographers began to expose the inadequacy of quantitative methods of to explain and address issues regarding race, gender, class, and war. Cuver was also criticized on the following ground: the man and environment relationship cannot be properly established by the mechanistic models designed with the help of quantitative techniques. Geometry, the language of Cuver, quantitative relation was unable to explain the man-environment relationship. By excluding the normative question, geographic study become parochial. The assumptions that man has infinite knowledge of his space or environment has also been criticized. In the real world, location decisions are seldom optimal in the sense of maximizing profits. In the opinion of Simon, man in a number of alternatives on that is broadly satisfactory rather than optimal. Models developed with the help of quantitative techniques reduce people, decision makers, workers, and passive agents to a large extent. Such models may be seen as the quantitative as one of quantitative determinism. Okay, thank you.